Morning, everyone, and welcome to Total Body Toning. Total Body Toning, we have three standing exercises we're going to do for three rounds, and then we'll take a halfway break and do some three ground exercises for the second half. First standing exercise, we're going to do legs first. I'll always give the option to just do a round of squats if you don't feel comfortable doing what leg we're going to do, because it's a little more advanced and aggressive. We're going to do a reverse lunge. So you stand up tall. You need to hold on to something. You can hold on to a chair or a wall or anything like that. You're going to step back. You can drop down very little. You can step back, drop down all the way to the ground if you feel comfortable. And we're just going to alternate each leg, stepping backwards. Don't go forward. Forward makes our knees go forward, and I want to protect the knees, so we'll go backwards only. Squats are your alternative, okay? So let's go in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Here we go. You can go as deep as you feel comfortable. You don't have to go all the way to the ground. You can go very shallow, almost just like a step back. Or you can go much deeper and get more flexion in that knee, get you more quad strength. And squats are your alternative. Good, keep going. We're going to get 15 seconds more in this one. Five, four, three, two, one. All right. Let's stand up tall. Let's grab a set of weights. We're going to do a curl and a press. I would say try not to go over 5 pounds just for the press part. If you have a shoulder injury, you're going to want to skip the press part overall. So there's two parts to this exercise. First one is you're going to hold your weights to your side. You're going to curl up, press up. Back to the shoulders, bring it down, bring it down. Curl it up, press it up. So if you got that shoulder injury, you're just going to do curl up, curl down. Don't do the overhead press part. Okay? So stand up tall, good base with the feet. Let's go in 3, 2, 1, here we go. Curl, curl, press. Don't lean back. Down, down. You want to keep your core nice and tight when you press up overhead so we don't put that weight through our spine. We want to keep that through the abs. Good. Doesn't matter which you want to curl up first. Just make sure you keep a tight core. Don't lean back. Good, almost there. We're going to do two more starting right now. So here's one, 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 two, two, two. Good. All right, hang on to one of those weights. Next one. So that was a bicep and shoulder. We're going to do arms while we're standing. So that was bicep, shoulder. This one we're going to do triceps. So we're going to do this whole upper arm part. We're going to go right hand with the weight to start. Let's get the left foot out in front. Left hand or forearm can go on that front leg. We're going to do a kickback. So a kickback, pull the elbow up. You're going to squeeze it in tight. You're going to extend the weight back nice and slowly. And just keep that elbow nice and still. Okay? So go right hand with the weight. Nice forward lean. You can hold on to anything around you if you want to. We'll go in 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Pull the elbow up. Extend back nice and slowly. Good. Keep a nice slow pace. Good. The more you can get a nice forward lean going without hunching your back, the better. It's more comfortable on your shoulder. You're going to get more tricep involved, less shoulder. We can do two more of them. Good. All right, we'll stand up. We're going to change the hands. Let's go left hand with the weight. Right foot, right arm go out in front. Good forward lean. Pull the elbow up and extend that one back nice and slow. Okay, elbow does not move. The less the elbow moves, the better. Thank you. We got three more to go. When you've done your three, you can stand up. You can place your weight off to the side. We don't need it for the next round through. So weight goes off to the side. Starting back with the legs again. So you're going to want a little space behind you. Your modified exercise would just be doing a set of squats. Okay? If you can do it, a little more advanced, you're going to do reverse lunging. You step back, you go shallow, or you can go really deep to the ground. Leave that up to you how far you want to go. Let's go in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Step back, drop down. You're going to notice my front knee stays nice and stationary. It's not moving forward. It's not moving backwards. We're going to keep it nice and still. All it's going to do is just bend on the way down. Good. Hold a nice, smooth rhythm. Definitely don't do this one quickly. You put more pressure on your joints. So you want to do it nice and slow, nice and controlled. Let's take the pressure off the joints. And at the same time, working the muscles a little harder. We got 10 more seconds. To the last one. All right, and we'll stand up. Grab a set of weights. If you're doing just curls and you're not doing the overhead press, you could probably do a little bit heavier weight if you want to. If you're doing the pressing, you're probably going to want 5 pounds or less. It really doesn't take much weight to overhead press. So we're going to take our Y stance, weights to the side. We're going to do our curl, curl, press, back to the shoulders, curl down, okay? All right, here we go. Let's curl up. Press up, tight core, don't lean back. Back to the shoulders. You can go one down at a time, both down at a time. Doesn't really matter too much if you lose your rhythm a little bit. You're going to notice I do it once in a while too. Good. Don't forget about using your abs. They get a very robotic motion almost, like you're going very stiff. One, press, back down, so it's very robotic. That way we're in nice control. Last one coming here, we got one. All right, we just need one dumbbell for the kickbacks. Kickbacks is the back of the arm, so we're doing the whole arm again, okay? So let's go left hand with the weight just to change it up. Left hand with the weight, right foot goes out in front first. Right arm can go out in front. Either your hand, preferably I like forearm because it gets you a nice further forward knee, but I'll leave that up to you. Pull the elbow up, you can do it with me or pull up, squeeze it in tight. Here we go. Kick back nice and slow. Make sure you're not swinging the weight. You're gonna do a slow pull with it. All right, elbow up. Arm stays really close to your side. Don't let your arm get out really wide. We got to protect the shoulder. We're going to get 10 seconds to go on this one. Why don't we do 3 more from here? 2 more. Should be your last one. All right, we always stand up first, change hands. Let's gather our balance, gather everything again. All right, good forward lean. Right arm pulls up, squeeze in tight. Here we go, right arm. It's a 30 second each arm. It gets you about 10, depending on how quickly you're going, maybe 15 repetitions. All right, we got 3 to go. All right, when we're done the 3, you can stand up. Place your weight down. We don't need it for our last series of leg exercise. We're going to do 3 sets. We're going to work these muscle groupings 3 times through so we can get them nice and tired. Okay. Last round through, we have our reverse lunging. Or squats, you could just do a series of squats as a leg alternative. Reverse lunging, start with good tall posture. You always want to finish with that tall posture between each lunge. In two, one, here we go. Step back, drop down. You're coming all the way up, good posture, stand up tall. And then we go to the other one. All the way up, nice posture, nice and tall. Okay, take your time, easy on the joints. Doing it slower gives you more control over pressure on the joints. It also makes your muscles work a little bit harder. You have 15 seconds to go. Five, four, three, two, one. All right, we'll take a pause right there. Grab our set of weights for our curl and press. 5 pounds or less is preferable, just because of the press part. It doesn't really take much weight to press overhead. Shoulders are very a weak, small set of muscles. So let's give ourselves a good base. We're gonna go single curl, press up. Then curl down, all right, here we go. Go ahead, curl up, press up, tight core, don't lean back. Back down, back down. You'll notice my motion's very robotic. It's one, it's pressing, so it's very segmented. Try not to press too far in front of your body too. You gotta press straight up in the air as you can. That way we protect the shoulders. We got two more to go. Here's one, two. Okay, place one of those down. We'll do our last hit, standing exercise. And it doesn't matter which hand you want to do, your opposite foot goes out in front with the opposite hand. So if you got the weight in the right hand, that means our left foot, left arm go out in front. All right, take a nice forward knee. We'll go in three, two, one. Pull the elbow up, tricep kick back. You're gonna keep the elbow tight, nice and still. Extend the weight back nice and slow. Let's get three more in. All right, when you're done your three, you're gonna stand up, change hands, change your foot position. You're gonna swap feet. Good forward lean. Here we go, pull the elbow up. Extend back, go ahead. 30 seconds each arm. Do three more. And when you've done your three, you can place your weight down, grab a drink. We'll take a 45-second-ish break. We're going to do ground exercises. So if you want to bring your weights on down to the ground, we're going to finish the second half up with some ground stuff. All right, as you're getting set up, I'm going to start showing you what our first ground exercise is going to be. We have a single arm chest press. So you're going to lie on your back. You're going to have bent knees. We're going to have one single weight. I'm going to place mine on my right arm first. I'm going to have my arm straight up in the air. Tighten my core. I'm going to let my elbow fall to the ground, let the arm bend. When the elbow hits the ground, you're gonna press all the way back up. So we're just gonna do a single arm chest press. It looks like so. You keep your core nice and tight. I don't want you to twist your body when you do it, okay? So we'll go in about 10 seconds or so. Grab a single weight, lie on your back, give yourself some bent knees. We're gonna start straight up in the air with the weight. So grabbing your arm, place your arm straight up to the ceiling. This is where I want your finishing point to be, okay? So from here, I'll let the elbow go down to the ground, press all the way back up to that same point we just started at, okay? So you're gonna start and stop at that same point. Here we go, just press it up, single arm, 30 seconds set each arm. Nice and slow. Just the biggest thing you should know when you do this is when you let your elbow down to the ground, the weight should not be out wider than your elbow. If it is, you would put yourself at a serious risk of a shoulder injury. So you want to make sure the weight's at least over your elbow or closer to your body. Let's go two more. Last one. Good. Transfer over to the other hand. Try not to do it above your head just in case you lose control of it or drop it. Let's go straight up with the left arm. And here we go. Elbow down to the ground. Press all the way back up. Nice and smooth. Smooth to the ground with the elbow. Press all the way to that start point, all the way up to the ceiling. Want that full extension with the arm. Already halfway through. Two more. Last one. Good. Bring that weight in. You can place that down off to the side. Our next exercise is going to be a single leg glute bridge. So what that means is I'm going to take my left foot, cross it over my right leg. I'm going to take my right foot. I'm going to be on the heel so the toe points up towards the ceiling. From here, I place my hands out nice and wide so I have a good base with my body. I'm going to lift up by pushing off that heel. I'm just going to lift straight up to the ceiling with my hips, okay? So take your left leg, cross it over your right. Point the toe up on the foot that's on the ground, so you're pointing up at the ceiling, so you should be pushing off your heel. And let's go in 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Pressing up and down. If the single leg is too much, you can always just do a regular bridge, which is just having both feet on the ground. Lifting up and down. Five, four, three, two, one. Okay, bring the hips all the way to the ground. You're going to cross your other leg over. The foot that's on the ground, you want that to be on the heel so your toes is pointing up a little bit. In 3, 2, 1, here we go. We're pushing up off of that heel. Seven. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Take a pause. Here's what we're going to do next. Is we're going to do a hip exercise for our third exercise on the ground. I'm going to have you lie on the side. This is called a hip circle. So I'm going to lie on my side. The top leg, doesn't matter which leg it is because we're going to do both sides. We're going to lift up the leg. We're going to create a small circular pattern with our leg, keeping our toes and hips facing forward, not towards the ceiling. All right? And then we're going to reverse it, and we're going to go in the opposite direction. I'll tell you when to reverse, okay? So lie on your side, top leg. We'll lift in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Small circular pattern. And reverse it. Four, three, two, one. Good. Bring that leg down. We're going to switch to the other side. Let's take that top leg, lift up, and here we go. Start a circle. Three, two, one, reverse. Five, four, three, two, one. Good, take a pause. We're gonna go back through that series again so you can lie on your back. We're going to have a single dumbbell, just one weight. This, it's a chest exercise. Your chest is pretty strong, so if you want to go a little heavier, you can with it. I can say some people could probably go up to 10 pounds comfortably. You're going to lie on your back, bent knees. We're going to go straight up in the air with the weight. Just one weight. We let that elbow come to the ground, and then we press all the way back up. Let's go in three, two, one. Here we go. 30 seconds each arm. Nice slow pace. Everything that involves the shoulder, which this one does, we do it at a slow pace. Otherwise, we put our shoulder at risk of injury. Let's go one more. Again, do not transfer over your head. Do it over your torso or pull the weight all the way in your body and switch it over. All right, go straight up in the air with the other arm. In three, two, one. Here we go. Go to one more. Okay, you can place that weight off and down to the side. Next up, we have single leg bridge. You're gonna cross one leg over the other one. Foot that's on the ground, I want you to be on the heel so that your toe points up. Your hands, it's helpful to have them out wide, just gives you a good solid base to push off the ground with. And then you just lift up the hips with that heel, okay? Let's go in five, four, three, two, one. Go ahead, 30 seconds. If single leg is too hard, again, you can always just do a two-leg bridge, which I'll do right now if you want to see what that looks like. Five, four, three, two, one. Okay, take that leg down, cross the other leg over. Foot that's on the ground, you're gonna point the toe up so you're pushing off your heel. And here we go, press up again, 30 seconds. Good, already halfway there. And up to 10 seconds left. Let's go one more. Good. All right, next up, lying aside. We have our side hip circle. So we take the top leg, we lift up. We create a circular pattern, halfway through, we reverse it, we create a circular pattern in the opposite direction, okay? If you're wondering how long it is, we do 15 seconds and 15 seconds. So take the top leg, lay on either side, lift up. Here we go, start a circle. Five, four, three, two, one, reverse. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Okay, let's reverse sides. All All right, take the top leg, lift up, here we go. 15 seconds this direction. Three, two, one, reverse it. The higher the leg, the harder it is. Just make sure you're not gonna point the toe up at the ceiling. Five, four, three, two, one. Good, bring that leg down. All right, last round through. Let's grab our single dumbbell. We're going to start with the arm straight up in the air. Doesn't matter which arm you want to do. This is our starting and end point. Let's go in three, two, one. Here we go. Elbow to the ground, elbow presses up. Elbow to the ground, arm presses up. 30 seconds each arm. Two more. Last one. Okay, let's switch to the other hand. Not over your head. Arm goes straight up. Here we go. Two more. Last one. All right, you can place that off to the side. Do not need the weight. We have two exercises to go. The first one's going to be our single leg glute bridge. You cross one leg over the other one. Foot on the ground, you're gonna be on the heel so the toe points up. And then we push up off that heel so we lift the hips up. Let's go in three, two, one. Go ahead, push up off that heel, or you have the choice for a regular bridge, which is just with two legs. We do 30 seconds, and I'll let you know. We'll switch to the other leg. Go one more. Okay, let's change the legs. Switch over. Same deal, here we go. Let's go two more. Good. All right. Turn to your foot lying on a side. We have our side lying hip circle. Be our last one today. So, lying your side. Top leg lifts up. And here we go. Create a circular pattern. The higher the leg, the harder again. Okay. Just make sure you're gonna keep your toes and your hips facing the wall, not the ceiling. If you have to point the toe up, you're a little too high with the leg. Bring the leg down a little. Reverse. Three, two, one, change sides. We'll go in 5 seconds. Here we go. Lift up, circle. Reverse. 3, 2, 1. All righty. And you can bring the leg down. Have a nice weekend and thank you for coming to class, everybody.